Hey Leo, I hope you're doing well. This is going to be a general reading for three major events in your life. Any information you need, you can find it in the description box down below, Leo. I do have personals open right now. There are two different options. There's a two-question video read and a three-question video read. If you get the three-question video read, you can get it within 2 business days. So details are down below for anybody who may be interested. We're going to go ahead and begin here, okay? So somehow this is going to be major for you. It could involve an old woman. Okay, we got sadness, female, showing up here, Leo. So we're going to clarify. We're going to see what's going on there with that. You also have mountain, challenges, achievements. Okay, then you have dove, peace and serenity. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at the old woman. What is going on with this for Leo? Why is this a major event in Leo's life? Page of Cups. It could be a water sign. You know, I feel like somebody, it's not necessarily that it has to be an old woman. That's just what they label this card here, like the way they label mountain. It's not literally going to be a mountain, right? But it could be a challenge, right? Where you are overcoming a challenge. It's similar with the old woman card, right? They're labeling it sadness or maybe something to do with a female. We do have the Page of Cups showing up right here, an emotional conversation coming your way. I feel like there could be something that's stirring up your emotions. Pages are messengers. It could come from someone younger, you know, ironically, right? Because we have the old woman card, but pages can sometimes represent, like, they're the children of the court cards. It could just be a childlike energy, something that was very playful and it turned serious very quickly. Let's see what else we have there for it. Six of Cups, someone from your past. It could be a Scorpio. It's someone from your past here, okay? You could have blocked this person or you felt like you were over something here, Leo. And, you know, don't attack me for that because it happens. It happens. Sometimes you think you're over something and you're not, you know? So I feel like your emotions are being stirred up by something here. Let me see what else we have there for that. This could happen in the month of May. This could happen in the month of May, okay? Put that back here. The mountain, challenges, achievements for Leo. Why is this showing up as a major event in Leo's life? Nine of Cups, support. I feel like there's a lot of support. You know how they say it's lonely at the top? I don't think that's going to be the case for you. I feel like you're making it to the top, but there's so much support. Leo, some of you could be a public figure or you might become a public figure. You know, I feel like you're winning at something. You pushed through a very difficult challenge, and I feel like a lot of people have watched this, and I think there's a lot of support here for sure. You got the Six of Swords showing up right here. Transition. You know, I definitely think you're moving through like a really, really tough journey, like fight of your life type of energy. You can see these tumultuous waters moving up and down. I think that's why so many people are watching and supporting, because it does look impressive. You know, I feel like people are impressed, and you couldn't not be, you know? It's that type of energy here. You can see the calm and still waters over on the other side. You make something look effortless. You make something look effortless to these folks here. You could be moving as well, like changing residence. This could happen in October for some. We're going to look at the Dove, peace and serenity, Ten of Swords. Ooh. You know, and I think that it's, I felt like this went without saying, but I guess I'm going to say it anyway here. But, you know, like I said, it's not going to be lonely at the top for you, but I do think that it could be a little bit lonely on the way up, because I feel that when you get into this, like when you have this victory here, Leo, I feel like you're going to be in alignment with people who think like you, people who uplift, support, motivate. But I think that on the way there, you could have people who are discouraging, who are trying to just kind of drag you back down to the bottom. And I think that's something that you're going to let go of. Ten of Swords, Three of Swords. And it's going to be hard. You know, it's going to be hard. These could be relationships that you've had for a long time. I don't think you're letting go of everyone. I don't feel like that's the case. I don't think it's that extreme. But I do feel like you're letting go of a lot of people who are holding you back. You know, maybe all of your conversations consist of like gossip or complaints about like work or, you know, this hurts, that hurts. You know, it's like there's a lot of that type of bond that you could have with a certain group of people here. Even if it's just like one or two people, it doesn't have to be a group, but I do feel like it is, you know, for a lot of you, I feel like it is. There are certain people here who it's like, if you're not talking about other people or if you're not complaining, you really don't have much to talk about with one another. You know, so I feel like for a lot of you, you're cutting those energies out. It's just time. Some of you, you could be realizing that a person who does, like, I just get the energy of gossip. You know, Ten of Swords can be a betrayal. So for some, like, this may be something that has like directly happened to you. Maybe people are gossiping about you, and so you're cutting them out here. You know, and it's sort of like that energy too of you know, I think you could be realizing, gosh, this person that I speak with, all they do is speak about others. I know they're doing it to me too. I'm not the exception, right? I feel like a lot of you could be realizing that as well. A lot of certain habits you're putting an end to. And it, again, it's not just like, I don't really feel like it's just relationships. I don't really feel like it's just a person or two. I feel like it's also certain habits. You know, maybe you engage in that type of behavior and you're just done with it. You realize it's, you know, dragging down your energy here. And I feel like you're trying to operate in the highest vibration possible. I think that's why the happiest card in the deck is out here, because I feel like you're achieving that for sure. I feel like you're creating a new sense of self, because you know the sun in astrology represents the self, and I feel like that is what you're doing. You're kind of reinventing yourself here. Queen of Wands, you're being more bold, you're taking more risks, you're doing things that scare you, and I feel like it's putting you in a really powerful position in life. I feel like it's putting you in a much higher, like I feel like you're going to be much happier than you have been in a while. Something significant could happen in the month of July that brings you into this energy, but it feels really powerful. It does, okay? So that's what I'm seeing here. I hope that this was helpful or fun, Leo. Details are down below if you're interested in personals, but if this is where we part, thank you for being here. I really appreciate you, and I hope you'll see me next time. Bye.